were taking a stand in silent protest against widespread violence towards African Americans. By 1921, the organization's leaders agreed that Lift Every Voice should become the official song of the NAACP. One member of the organization, a Jewish rabbi, called Lift Every Voice the noblest anthem he had ever heard. And he said of the song, "It is a great upwelling of prayer from the soul of a race long wronged, but with faith unbroken." Faith unbroken. And ever since then, in the decades to follow, individuals and organizations throughout the South and around the world sang Lift Every Voice and See at events ranging from festivities to protests, and even used their own languages to express the sentiments of the song. For example, in 1930, Lift Every Voice was sung in the Ovimbundu language of Angola in Southwest Africa. In 1936, the song was published in Japanese. Can you imagine that? Now, why would people of different races and from other parts of the world begin to sing this song? Because it is a song that speaks to the desire for freedom and equality. And that desire is universal. But the song also inspired other writers and artists. Take, for example, the great African-American sculptor, Miss Augusta Savage. She created this majestic interpretation of the song in 1939, a plaster sculpture 16 feet high with 12 singers lifting their voices up to God, whose hand is the sounding board of the harp. But it was not until 5 years ago, in 2011, that 500 school children would come together as one body to sing the song again in the manner that it was sung on that very first occasion in Jacksonville in 1900. Emory University professor Rudolph Bird had a vision to bring the Johnson Brothers' work back to life in a very special way, right here in Atlanta. Dr. Bird was the founder of the James Weldon Johnson Institute, my organization. And in tribute to the Johnson Brothers, Dr. Bird organized the first 21st century chorus of 500 youth voices singing Lift Every Voice and Sing. And guess what? Although Dr. Bird is no longer alive, it is thanks to him that all of you are going to make history here again today. I'm going to leave you with reflections from some of those kids who sang in 2011. I'm sure they'll inspire you as much as they do me. Thanks to all of you for your attention and enthusiasm, and I can't wait to hear those voices lifted in song for freedom and equality.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.